All right, people, what's up, everyone, and welcome to another reaction video for today. And it's a good day indeed. It always is when there is a new Indie World out, of course, from Nintendo. Always a good time. Get to see some cool indies, some shadow drops, always dropping out of the shadows, that's why I call that. Good time. I wish I knew ahead of time I would have done a stream for this. I guess I could have still, but it would have felt weird if I streamed something that everybody already saw. And also, you know, looking at the chat, people might have spoiled things like, yo, Hollow Knight's at the end. Be like, all right, thanks. So I'll just record this one. Okay, just this one. And maybe in the future, if I know ahead of time, maybe I'll do an Indie World stream. We'll see. Have I ever streamed the Indie World? I don't even think I have. Anyway, I have no idea. So let's get to it. 20 minutes? Roughly 20 minutes. Does say we have another 26 minutes left of the stream, so maybe a little bit longer. I don't know. Or the last few minutes is like just the screen. I don't know. I guess let's find out. You ready? You ready? Yeah? Yeah? Okay. Let's go. 3, 2, 1, and play. Give me the goods. Give me the goods. Give me the goods. Yes. Yes. Give me the goods. Oh, where's Bear and Breakfast? Don't screw with me.
Hello!
Hey!
Welcome to Indie World. I'm Amber.
What's up, Amber? What's up, Paul?
We're about to show you some indie games coming to the Nintendo Switch.
Amber
system.
And Paul.
Let's dive right in!
Oh, I think this is on Kickstarter. I was gonna back it. Sea of Stars, right? I think this is on Kickstarter. It was somewhere I was gonna buy like a collector's edition for it. I never did. I think it's Sea of Stars. It looks really good. Was this already confirmed to come out on Switch though? Or is it out today? Too many games, bro. I hope it's not out today. Oh, I'm a fart cloud. Now you fight me! Yeah, this looks really good. Sabotage. Wow, it's a sabotage.
Fans of classic RPGs with modernized elements will want to check out Sea of Stars.
Looks really good.
It tells the story of two children of the solstice, a lunar monk and a solar blade dancer.
Oh, of course.
They must combine the powers of the sun and the moon to perform eclipse magic, the only thing that can fend off monsters created by an evil alchemist known as the Fleshmancer.
Oh, okay.
Fluid and engaging. That's a good name. Combat.
The Fleshmancer.
Stunning dynamic lighting. A world where you can traverse freely and explore every nook and cranny. And that's just scratching the surface. Not to mention the incredibly moving story with plenty of twists and turns.
I was hoping that story's up to par.
The same universe as The Messenger and serves as a
prequel. Oh!
Don't worry,
I know it was made from the makers, but... To fully enjoy good, I haven't played it.
And get this. Some of the music was composed by none other than the renowned Yasunori Mitsuda, who composed music for Chrono Trigger, Cross, and Xenoblade Chronicles 2.
I'm not good with names. Love Chrono Trigger.
Sea of Stars launches on Nintendo Switch Holiday 2022.
Whoa. Yeah, no, they still need some time, obviously. A whole year. I was about to say, because I think they had a Kickstarter. They had something, because I was going to buy a... They had a collector's edition. I think Limited Run was like advertising for them. Ooh, this looks nice. I like her beady eyes. I remember like Adventure Time. A lot of the characters in that have beady eyes. Alicia? Alicia?
Hi,
so
Nick.
So guys.
Underscore Team.
Oh no, I'm gonna cry, bro.
Bye.
I'm gonna cry and smile.
There's plenty to admire in this puzzle adventure game. For twin sisters, Aisha and Leisha, cooperation is key in safely navigating this deserted temple. The game makes creative use of the various input options available on Nintendo's Switch. Each sister is controlled differently, and you can control both via solo or local co-op play.
Okay, so it's like Brothers, kind of, where you can play by yourself? Well, I guess Brothers you can't really play with.
And with Leisha, you'll use touch controls to guide the helper robot Ambu in handheld mode.
Okay.
However you choose to play, you'll need the sisters to work together.
Brothers and Tales of Two Sons, technically you can play co-op on Switch. Because you can give somebody the other Joy-Con.
But be careful. It's filled with all sorts of menacing monsters and treacherous traps.
I'm scared.
Some of which can trigger different endings. The heartfelt, overlapping music when playing with a friend, coupled with the emotional story, will complement your journey to uncover the secrets residing within.
Alicia, the Oblivion of Twin Goddesses, launches as a console exclusive on Nintendo Switch, spring 2022.
Looks pretty good.
Keep an eye on that one. I'm Adam.
What's up, Adam?
We're two brothers who started our own indie studio in order to make a classic point-and-click adventure game. Today, we're excited to announce our debut title, Locomotive. Set aboard a 1930s express train, you find yourself caught in the middle of a deadly mystery.
Oh, twists, turns, like the motive? That's a great title.
Some satisfying puzzles. Locomotive.
That's what Murder on the Orient Express should have been called.
And it's been a long-term ambition for us to put our own spin-off. We can't wait for you to play Locomotive when it comes to the Nintendo Switch system.
Welcome aboard the Royce Express, where my guests indulge in luxury travel.
Love it. Okay, totally in. My dad! Oh no, she's dead.
Who's at hand to catch my killer? There's my trusty lawyer, a would-be detective, and Her Majesty's Secret Service. There's just one problem.
Osterhagen?
They're the suspects. With puzzles to solve, palms to grease, and clues to uncover. They'd better prove their innocence fast, or it's the end of the line.
Whose voice is this?
That's not just nuts.
Oh, yikes.
It's Locomotive!
I'm in. Is that out today?
Ooh, I do love murder.
I love Grandma Murder.
Locomotive, a single-player point-and-click comedy adventure.
That's pretty good.
Climb aboard the Royce Express and investigate the suspicious death of Lady Unterwald.
You'll play as a straight-laced lawyer, an amateur detective, and an undercover agent at different points in the story. Along the way, you'll meet a fully voiced cast of quirky characters
fully voiced.
And solve head-scratching puzzles to prove...
I was hoping just the trailer wouldn't have the voice, and that's it.
Figure out who done it, and what locomotive inspired them to murder in the first place.
I love the...
Steamrolls on Nintendo Switch.
I love the little animations, too. It actually reminds me of a Ghost Trick on the DS.
Dama, wake up!
Oh, Coffee Dog. And what comes out? I actually thought What Comes After was pretty good. I played that. It was a heartfelt story. About guitars.
Your friends are waiting for you. Come on.
Man, can you help me this goal? Hey. Alright, we get a jam. After Love EP. Okay. She's dead.
From Indonesia.
I was trying to think, like, what's the hook there? Oh, she passes away, and as a ghost, she tells him to keep going on. Alright, I get you.
Loving others as well as yourself. While the game is heavily inspired by the aesthetic and storytelling format of the Japanese manga, the game itself is set in Jakarta. We want players to experience this vibrant place we call home, which is also considered as the melting pot of the multicultural people of Indonesia. We cannot wait to let you experience our unique narrative adventure and explore our
interpretation. That one I'm actually interested in. I'm in the mood to cry like a bitch.
From the creative director of What Comes After and Coffee Talk comes a stirring narrative about love, loss, and lyricism. Set in Jakarta, Indonesia, After Love EP focuses on young musician Rama, who struggles to compose music after his girlfriend Cinta passes away. By communicating with Chita's voice inside his head, Rama will learn how to cope with grief, forge new relationships, and even potentially love again.
A mixtape, a visual novel, rhythm game, and narrative adventure?
Sounds emotional.
The EP challenges you to complete an
I'm in the mood
to
cry.
Fulfill a promise made to Chita. There are multiple endings based
yet.
On the choices you make.
Can you
as
just
well
open
as an
me,
original
like,
soundtrack
speed
from
run?
Indonesian band Alfalfa. And striking art direction from Soyatu.
Start anew in
wow,
After
okay.
Love EP. Launching on Nintendo
I thought that would be earlier. I wasn't thinking that was going to be a shadow drop, but I thought that would be like early. Oh, more pixel art. Wait, what? What is happening? Should fly in his hands. Don't get too cocky. Start with three basics. Monster Hunter, ingredient collecting, and food. Something. What the fuck? You put a gun in there? Did I see a gun in there? So, what the hell? So you use food to make weapons. Alright, I'm in. Well, eat me! Eat me! Okay. I will. No problem, bro. As long as you're okay with it. Dungeon Munchies. That actually looks really good. So far?
I'm hungry.
Good.
I've got the munchies. Dungeon munchies,
you've been
that is.
Doing a little
this
of this.
2D side-scrolling action.
Been token it up, girl.
Should definitely
you got the munchies.
By your craving, you are dead. Well, you were dead.
I wish you did that
right there.
You are dead.
Mysterious underground facility. But forget
don't
hanging
you fucking
here.
Threaten me, Paul.
You've get
or
out.
Frank, or whatever your name
with
was.
With the help of the undead necro chef Simmer, you'll hunt
Simmer.
Down monsters, then cook and eat them. There are around 100 dishes that provide various abilities.
Okay.
One dish, for example, might give you the
I love the face of the frying pan.
So you are what you eat.
Literally, this game is a great place to get locally sourced and farm fresh monsters.
Spider-dagger.
So mix and match to get the right meal for your playstyle. And let's not forget the eclectic cast of characters.
Eat me!
Hilarious side-splitting story and charming 2D pixel art. Better bring a voracious appetite when Dungeon Munchies devours its way onto the Nintendo
yeah.
system later today.
I feel like whenever they say, like, you better do this, it's good. It means it's coming out today. All right, that one I might check out. It looked pretty good.
Yeah, there's been musik I over 10 år.
Game music.
Vores kommende spil, Figment 2, fyldt med masser af musical boss fights og andre lydlæggerier.
I think I remember seeing Figment.
Har jeg været ude ved mit træsvær og smadret på havegriller og kaffekanner.
Huh?
Musikken i Figment indordner sig efter dig. Vi har brugt rigtig meget energi.
Yeah, I remember that
musik og gameplay til at spille sammen.
For Figment 1.
Og vi glæder os rigtig meget til at vise jer spillet.
What the wait?
I'm coming back to the surface. I need time to make things right. So hold on and soon comes the day.
So the game, while you're playing...
Yep, this isn't a figment of your imagination.
Oh, very funny. In this musical puzzle adventure game, you'll make your way through a rhythmic world set in the human mind.
So yeah, you while you're playing, it adapts, the song adapts to how you're playing, I guess.
It's up to you to put an end to their fearsome schemes. Play solo or locally with a friend as you
wield
your trusty sword and engage in combat. Manipulate environments to solve compelling puzzles and have symphonic showdowns against some musically menacing bosses.
Symphonic showdown.
That sounds like trouble. Or trouble.
Figment 2, Creed Valley begins its symphony on Nintendo Switch February 2022.
Is Michael B. Jordan going to show up?
A free demo will be available
free demo.
On Nintendo eShop.
Ooh, that's a shadow drop, technically. Kind of.
Deep sea diving? Check. Investing? Check.
Oh, it's oh, like a bunch of board games?
Check.
Oh.
Surviving on the moon? Check that too.
It's like a tabletop simulator kind
of
thing.
Oink Games are coming to Nintendo Switch.
It's out today. Confirm. That's out today, right?
Deep sea adventure.
This is kind of cool.
Become the biggest
investor. Become the sugar glider.
Catch the sketchy rogue and don't get caught in.
Who's the fake artist?
Cover supplies with your fellow astronauts to survive in Moon Adventure. The games are designed to be easy to understand. They also capture and recreate the feel of their original tabletop versions.
You can play all the games, locally and online. All right, so you can play with friends God. Near and far.
Near, far, wherever you are.
One system,
this looks good.
Create a room with friends. More games will also
so you
be
can just play with random
future.
People, too. That's good.
Start a game night with Let's Play.
Yeah, I knew that was out today. 100%.
Nintendo Switch
time, a timed console exclusive.
Hi, I'm Javier, CEO and programmer at HeroVita Studios.
Hi, I'm Iris. I'm working as an environment artist for our upcoming title, Endling Extinction Isfaga.
We wanted to create a game that raises awareness about how the world may be in the near future if we don't change our consumption habits.
The environment is mainly presented during night, since we want to emphasize a fox's natural behavior and contrast a calm but deteriorating world and human threats during the day.
We hope that Endling may encourage everyone to reflect, but also that players around the world
probably lost them. Probably like wait.
Its story, gameplay, and
we started at what 20. Something, I think. No, it was like at 35 or no, it was like at 29 or something. So, actually, we only have a few minutes left. All right, so it's about Fox. No life, silence failed. That's some good imagery. Hey, Hey! Oh, hell no. Yo, no. Alright, I'm in. You got me. Extinction is forever. Alright, so the game was called Endling. Okay. I was wondering why you had that shirt on.
Endling, extinction is forever. You'll need to keep your three cubs alive and lead them to safety.
It's gonna be like a baby Mario situation.
In this game, blending stealth, survival,
oh,
and adventure,
shit.
You'll make your way
fuck
through
that.
Devastated environments to reach the one place on Earth where humans can't hurt you.
Mars.
Along the way, you'll hunt other animals to feed
wait,
your
what?
Cubs, as well as teach them new
that
skills to make them less vulnerable to predators. I really hope they make it.
I do too.
Why don't you play the game then?
The end,
it's probably out later today.
Your cubs survive the perilous journey is up to you.
Endling. Extinction is
no,
forever.
Never mind, it's not.
Launches on Nintendo Switch, Spring 2022.
That looks good, though.
Here's more info about the skateboarding action platformer Olly Olly World from our friends at Roll 7 and Private Division.
Hell yeah, Olly Olly World.
Far across the Olly Olly
I forgot it's in 3D now. I totally forgot.
Forged by the skate gods. Join your crew and travel across our
beautiful land. Yeah, this is BDI's planet. Again.
Wall ride among the trees. Forge new paths through the desert.
It's always been like 2D in the past.
Platforms in picturesque sketch side. You'll see some weird stuff along the way. But don't worry.
It just reminded me how much of a disappointment Skatebird was.
There you'll compete with champions, challenging each other's skills to win rewards.
That might be one of the biggest disappointments this year, honestly.
So come shred by the sea. Chase a bee. Meet a tree. Get on down.
Chase a bee. Meet a tree. Narvana.
Bonus items.
Nice. Bunny Lord.
Give me some of those.
Where's the Bunny Lord head come from?
Rolls onto Nintendo Switch February 8th, 2022.
Not too long.
Pre-orders begin later today on Nintendo eShop.
Hi, I'm Dan Arudis, director of River City Girls 2.
Oh, River City Girls 2.
Producer of River City Girls 2.
I've been a River City fan since the days of Nintendo Entertainment System, and in fact, this is the
River City Girls was pretty fun. I never finished it, but I had a really good time from what I played.
Sako, Kyoko, Kunio, and Ricky.
Oh, they brought the other two back in.
The first River City Girls. So, for the sequel, we're including everything players loved about the original, plus a whole lot more, including online co-op.
We're working really
hard. Yeah, that was the main reason why I didn't finish River City Girls.
In the meantime, please enjoy our debut trailer for River City Girls 2.
Alright, I'm in. Let's go. Yep, there you go, the other two. Huh. Bigger city. That was one cool thing about it. It was a kind of open world, I guess. Local and Love the pixel art. I'm glad games like this still exist. Just straight up beat 'em ups. That's what it does say. Thank you.
More baddies to take down? Let's go.
Right there with you. Way Forward is back with the sequel to the acclaimed beat 'em up River City Girls. There's trouble brewing once again in River City, with higher stakes, meaner streets, and even more over-the-top humor. Take control of one of six characters, including...
I did like some of the dialogue, actually. I was surprised by how much I thought it was actually funny.
Each character has their own fighting style and upgradable movesets, which you'll need as you set off on a new quest, picking up where the first game left off.
And when we say new, we mean it. New moves, enemies, areas, items... and a new soundtrack by the first game's composer, Megan McDuffie.
Hell
not
yeah.
To mention branching paths, as well as a return of a familiar foe. Get the fist flying solo, or team up with a friend, locally or online.
Just what games do you say,
Paul? Ready to give some goons
the you need Nintendo Switch Online?
Oh, heck yeah!
River City Girls 2 punches its way onto Nintendo Switch, summer 2022.
So I think we're about to wrap it up, right?
We've got several more indie games coming to Nintendo Switch. From painting the world to a management sim with dinosaurs.
Oh, we'll get a montage.
Enjoy!
Huh? I will. Thank you. Okay. Oh, yeah. That art game I really want. It's on Steam, but I really want to play it. Yeah, that game. I forgot what it's called. Parkasaurus? What? I want to play this. Oh, this looks good. Hell yeah, I want to play this. Is this out today? Yeah, eat them. Don't Starve Together. I didn't know this wasn't already on Switch. I know Don't Starve is on there. I just assumed Together was on there, too. Oh, yeah, Chicory. Oh, it's available today. All right, cool. Heard so many good things about this. All right, so there goes another Shadow Drop, I think at least. Unless we already knew it was coming to Switch. Shadow Drop to me, Baby Storm. What the hell? Oh no, it's like Overcooked with Babies. That's alright. I can't think of anything worse than Overcooked with Babies. Grime. I remember hearing about this game. Is this on PS4? Gerda, a flaming winter. They have Tekken Enders. Our day at war. Didn't say war, this is war. Timeline. Full game and free demo available later today. Okay, cool. Alright, looks like a puzzle game. I'm getting the vibe that you're not controlling her. Maybe. You have to like solve it before she starts moving. Behind the frame, that's the game. Wow, really? That long? It's already out. It's been out on Steam for like months. Just thought maybe that'd be a Shadow Drop. Might just play on Steam at that point. Looks really good. Okay. One last thing. Come on, you can't do a montage. Oh, never mind. I guess they can.
Or not.
Oh, no? Okay.
We've got one more game. Check
Hollow Knight. What is it? I still haven't played the first Hollow Knight. No, it's not Hollow Knight. Or wait, maybe? No, it's not Hollow Knight. What is this? Okay. Sleeping. Peaceful. Omori? Or Mari?
The critically acclaimed RPG, Omori, is making its way onto Nintendo Switch.
Wait, have I not heard about this?
Travel back and forth between two strange and vibrant worlds, each one brimming with colorful friends and foes to uncover a forgotten past. You'll experience an unconventional story and turn-based battle system, supplemented by warm illustrations by renowned artist Omoket, who also produced,
really good.
Wrote, directed, and coded much of the game. Omori does lean into some heavy topics, so be prepared. It's quite the journey.
It looks like it does.
Omori launches on Nintendo Switch spring 2022.
Okay. I was not expecting that. I've never even heard that game. Looks good, though.
We hope you enjoyed the lineup of games in today's Indies Showcase.
I did.
As always, we'd like to thank everyone in the indie community working on games for Nintendo Switch. And thank you for watching.
Don't forget to follow our official Twitter account to stay up to date on all the latest news from Indie World. Until next time, happy gaming.
You too, happy gaming. Bye. Okay. That was a pretty good one. Not a lot of ones I'm like super hyped for. I don't think I saw one game that was just like meh. All of them look really good to me. The board game one actually I'm kind of interested in, so I want to see how much that is. That Parkasaurus game, I need to see that montage again.
We've got sub to him.
What did it say again? Available spring 2022. Okay. I like these type of games. And you put dinosaurs in it? Shit, you got me, baby. What else? River City Girls 2 looks really good. After Love looks actually interesting. I might actually get that when it comes out. Because I actually like what comes after. I thought that was pretty good. And it seems like that's going to be their thing whenever they do story-based stuff like this. It'll always have after in the title, maybe. I could see that being their thing. Or was the other one called What Comes Before? Wait, actually, now I'm confused. I played it. It was one of my finished games this year. It was like an hour long, and it was a pretty good story. Not much to it. You just talk, pretty much. You're on a train. Like Locomotive, which looks good, too. Yeah, CS Stars looks so good. That's going to be the cross code of next year. Meaning it's going to be a game everybody loved and everybody thought was amazing. And then it got nominated for fucking nothing. It's like and not even just the Game Awards, for any place. We're like, okay, I've heard nothing but amazing things about this game. And then nobody nominated it. It's going to be the Wilder myth of this year. I mean, what are you going to do? Sometimes you're just not going to be right. All right. So, pretty good. Pretty good Indie Direct. I enjoyed it. So there you go. That is the Indie World Showcase for 12/15/2021. What a Christmas treat. Thank you, Nintendo. You fuck. Thank you, Nintendo. Ow, I like scrape myself on the blades of these. I need to clean these things. They're like dirty. You can't see, but they're kind of dirty. Anyway, there you go. That's it. Bye.